2 Corinthians is actually the fourth letter that Paul wrote to the church, but like a greatest hits collection, the Holy Spirit picked the two that we have for inspiration and inclusion in the New Testament. 2 Corinthians, it's a pretty unique book in the New Testament and in the Bible. It's basically Paul defending himself and his ministry against attackers inside and around the church. Charles Spurgeon said of 2 Corinthians, "On account of Paul's having put his finger on the mischief that was among them, the Corinthians turned on him and disparaged him. They questioned whether he was an apostle at all." 2 Corinthians is the church victorious over attackers. The key verse is chapter 6 through 11. A quick outline is chapters 1 through 7, Paul defends his ministry. Chapters 8 through 9, Paul defends the collection. Chapters 10 through 13, Paul versus the rebels. It was written around AD 55 during the third missionary journey. So the relationship that Paul had with the church at Corinth had soured. He says in 1:23, "It was to spare you that I refrained from coming again to Corinth." Then he says in 2:1, "I made up my mind not to make another painful visit to you." So what happened? Simply, Paul had challenged the church about a lot of stuff, and people in the church didn't like it. They rose up against him. They condemned his character. They condemned his apostleship, and they questioned his influence. There are other letters in the mix here and content that we don't have, but we do have this one, where Paul writes to the church to defend his ministry, collect money for the poor in Jerusalem, and just move on. Paul not only defends his personal decisions, though, but he also defends his message. He talks about the new covenant and its glory at length in chapters 3 and 4. He talks about living for Christ with perseverance and how our hope in Christ and death results in faithful living now in chapters 4 and 5. He talks about reconciliation. He talks about how to live for God correctly in the midst of unbelievers. He talks about his joy over those who have repented in chapters 5 through 7. This is normal Pauline stuff, but it just feels tense in this book because of the relational conflict, even when it isn't being directly addressed. Like Paul says in 6:11, "We've spoken freely to you, Corinthians. Our heart is wide open." And a really emotional appeal in 7:2, "Make room in your hearts for us." Paul then spends a few verses talking about how awesome Titus is and two chapters talking about the collection he's receiving for needy Jews in Jerusalem. He even encourages the church, even amidst the conflict. He says, "As you excel in everything, see that you excel in this act of grace also." He isn't asking them, though, for what they don't want to give. Paul says, "You're generous, and I thought it necessary to go on ahead to you and arrange in advance the gift that you've promised so that it may be ready as a willing gift, not as an exaction." After the two chapters on the specifics of giving, Paul circles back to the main theme of the church versus its attackers, specifically against himself, and he spends the final four chapters on this theme. He defends his authority in chapter 10. Paul had been accused of being weak in person, but strong by letter. He replies, "I don't want to appear to be frightening you with my letters." I sense a little sarcasm there. He says in verse 11, "Let such a person understand that what we say by letter when absent, we do when present." Paul isn't just trying to seem strong, though. It's not in his character. He actually spends two chapters here boasting of his weakness. It's a complicated text because it's very, like, sardonic, but effectively, he boasts, he brags, he defends himself against his opponents by saying that he's superior to them in what he's done. He received an incredible spiritual experience, a vision so powerful that he might boast about it, but to keep him humble, God sent a thorn in his flesh that actually made him physically weak, so that he wouldn't boast. He'd have to depend on Jesus alone to do his work, not on the spiritual experience that he had. He said in 11:30, "If I must boast, I'll boast of the things that show my weakness." And that thorn in the flesh is the ultimate depiction of that weakness. He never says what it is specifically. It's probably like a physical or spiritual or mental or emotional deficiency. He actually asked God 3 times to take it away, but God said, "My strength is sufficient for you. My power is made perfect in weakness." Paul goes on to share his hurt at his unfair treatment. He says, "I've been a fool. You forced me to it, for I ought to have been commended by you." He shares his heart for the church in chapter 13 and ties together his point from the last two chapters talking about Christ. He says, "For he was crucified in weakness, but he lives by the power of God. For we also are weak in him, but in dealing with you all, we live with him by the power of God." He closes in chapter 13. There's one phrase that pops out of that list. He says, "Aim for restoration." That's really his heart in this letter. So Paul planted this church in Corinth. They struggled with sin issues. He called them out on it. They turned on him. And he wrote 2 Corinthians to talk about how he wanted to collect money for the poor in Jerusalem, but mostly because he wanted to defend himself against these unreasonable, unnecessary, unfair, and untrue attacks. 2 Corinthians is a very unique book. Here we are in the 9 church letters that Paul wrote, and it fits totally into our narrative of Scripture. God created, man fell, Jesus promised, Jesus fulfilled, Jesus followed, Jesus, do you remember? Returning, and the Bible is God's word.